Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back to another card making video where I share lots and lots of ideas on how you can use the December card kit by Simon Says Stamp. Just like always, let's take a quick look on what's included. You will get this icicle paste along with a palette knife. You will also get this sparkle pen. It's one of those pens that you use to add some shine on different elements of your projects. This is silver and you need to unscrew, take out that ring and then screw it back again. You have to push at the bottom of that barrel and you will see that it comes through. And just discard that ring. This is a package of Ideology Bubbles, it's by Tim Holtz, and they are great for your mixed media projects or even for decoration. This is a needle tip applicator bottle, you can add your glue inside and you will have a fine tip applicator there. Also your little candy. And let's take a look at the pattern papers. Now the pattern papers make it super easy on this kit to make cards, multiple of them, and I will share lots and lots of ideas. You know that I always like to focus on the papers. Now you will also get these 3D decoupage papers. These are already cut out for you. All you have to do is to just pop them out and stick one on top of the other to create different layers for a really dimensional look. There are 5 of these pages in the kit and I'm going to show you how to put them together. These are little foam squares. You really need them for the 3D decoupage pages. A couple of envelopes are included and then this is the big clear stamp set. This gives you lots of elves and many other elements like ornaments and sentiments to use for your cards. And then just like always you get cardstock in 4 different colors. So let me take you through the process of how I make cards when I get one of these kits with lots of pattern papers. I am separating those pattern papers in 2 categories. The one on the right has very busy patterns. The one on the left has all those pages that can be used as separate elements that can work as focal points on a card. In a previous month where I shared ideas using one of the kits, I did share how I like to work with busy pattern papers. Today I'm going to focus on the other ones, the ones that have lovely images on top and they can work as card fronts for your projects. Now just by using these 3 pattern papers, I'm going to show you ideas on how you can make 9 cards out of them. I will also show you ideas on how you can play with the 3D decoupage papers. And although I will put together 12 cards on this video, by sharing all these ideas, you will be able to make even more. I just didn't have the time to put everything together. So for the first 3 cards, grab this pattern paper and cut out those 3 images. These are long and they are 6 inches in width, which means that they are perfect for mini slimline cards. The mini slimline cards that I usually make are 3 by 6, so this is perfect. So here I have 3 mini slimline cards that are 3 by 6, and when you place them on top, you can place them all the way towards the top, all the way towards the bottom, at the center, it's up to you. I'm going to show you a few ideas on how you can make them look more interesting though. Instead of just sticking the pattern paper on top of your card front, just add a few extra elements to make it look more interesting. So for this one, I did use one of the dies that cut out snowbanks. Just a curve is enough. If you don't have one of those dies, you can always use your scissors. And then I can stick that at the bottom of my card base. I'm also going to cut out a little bit from that paper, which is going to allow for a little border all around, makes it look more finished. And I'm going to do the same thing with the snowbank before I stick it down. To put all these layers together, I did use foam tape at the back, adding some dimension on a card, always makes it look more special. And now we have created the perfect little scene where any of those images can work on top of it. So I would go with the snowman and that little elf, but any of the rest of the images would work. Just stamp them, color them, cut them out and stick them on top. You will end up with a lovely card, plus you have that area here to stamp your sentiment. However, I'm going to show you another way since I'm focusing on pattern paper, and I'm going to look for little elements that I can cut out to embellish this card. So this would work great if you cut them out and embellish the top of some letters, for example. But for this card, I decided to go with these presents. I'm going to cut out a few of them so that I can stick them on top of my card. I'm just fuzzy cutting whatever I need, making sure that I leave a white border all around, which is going to make your life of fuzzy cutting really easy. And then I'm going to stick those presents on top of my card. Some of them are going behind the snow, some of them on the top. At the top, I do use foam square for one of them just to add some extra dimension. And you can see on this card I didn't add a big focal point, I just kept everything clean and simple. But again, you can use any of the images from the stamp set to place on top. And now all I have to do is to stamp my sentiment. I went with Happy Holidays and my ink matches the color of my background sky. However, here is what not to do. Always plan where your sentiment is going to go. This is something that I always forget. And since I have all this dimension and foam underneath my snow, it is really difficult for me to stamp my sentiment. However, I'm going to pretend that everything is perfect. After doing everything I could, even turning my Misty upside down, and I move on to the next step as if nothing has happened. I'm going to add some snow. I'm following the pattern of the snow that is already there. I'm just using my Nouveau Drops on top of it to make it look dimensional. You will see close-up photos of this card in a bit. I'm just going to put together the other two cards that have a similar look. And the images come from the same pattern paper. So here I just cut out a piece of red cardstock that was included in the kit. It is slightly bigger than my image, so it gives a little border on top and at the bottom. And I'm going to use foam tape at the back and stick it on top of my card base. For my sentiment, I decided to go with Merry Christmas, which I'm going to stamp with Versamark ink on top of this red cardstock. I'm going to apply white embossing powder and heat set it, and then with my scissors I will fuzzy cut around the letters just to make it look more fun, and I will stick it at the bottom of my card base. Now, instead of doing all that, you can go completely quick and simple by just stamping the sentiment on that white space you have. I'm finishing off my card again by using the same step as I did in the previous one. I am going over the snow with my Nouveau Drops to make it look dimensional. And let's move on and turn the last piece that we cut out from this pattern paper into a card. I did cut out a very thin strip of silver cardstock, which I'm going to place at the bottom of this panel. This was not included in the kit. If you don't have silver cardstock, you can use any of the colors that are already on the image. You can go with the red, for example. You just need an extra border there to help the image pop against the background. I'm going to stick that again with foam tape on top of my card base towards the top. That leaves enough space at the bottom to stamp a sentiment. Since I have that silver strip, it would look beautiful if I did emboss that with silver embossing powder. However, I decided to keep everything quite quick today since I'm making lots of cards. And finally, I did add my dimensional snow with Nouveau Drops. And before I move on showing you even more ideas, let's take a quick look on all the three cards that I made using just this pattern paper. Remember, your cards don't always have to be complicated to be beautiful. Sometimes all the work is done by the beautiful pattern papers. So for my next cards, I'm going to play with these pages that have all those cutout elements where you layer the images one on top of the other to create a three-dimensional element. It is really easy to put together. There are even labels like layer 1, layer 2, layer 3, etc. And you stick one on top of the other by using foam tape. This creates kind of a depth where you have images far at the background and others at the front. You will end up with 5 different layers. This is going to make your element super dimensional, and it's not going to fit really nicely inside the standard envelope. That's why I'm going to do a trick here. If you notice, the second layer is exactly the same as the image at the background. So I will completely omit the second layer. You see, this is the one that I'm talking about. I'm just not going to use it. I will save one layer of foam tape. My finished element is not going to be as bulky, and at the same time, bonus, I end up with an extra focal point to use on another card. So you can either use your foam tape that you maybe have at home, or go with the tiny little foam squares that are included in the kit, and just build up the layers. And you can see the elf with a green hat looks far at the background. Then I'm adding the signs on top of that, the snowball and the bird. The finished element is just adorable with all that dimension. Hopefully you can see that. And it makes a great focal point, plus I have an extra image for another card. Now I'm going to repeat the same process with all the rest of the pages, and by the magic of video editing, here they are all ready to go. And for all of them, I did omit the second layer, so I have a bunch of extra elements to use for other cards. Now, since these are square, I'm going for a 4.25 by 4.25 square card, which fits in a standard envelope. I'm just going to stick those elements on top, keep it clean and simple. And as a finishing touch, I brought out my corner chomper. I'm going to use the 1/4 side, and I'm just going to round up the corners to match the rounded corners of my main focal image. You can stamp a sentiment on a thin strip of paper and stick it on top. I decided to go with these stickers that are already made for me, quick and simple method. And again, all of these cards kind of have a theme with Nouveau Drop, so wherever I see some snow, I'm going to add on top of it my Nouveau dots. And remember, I do have all the second layers, and I'm going to show you an idea on how you can use those in a bit. And here are some close-up photos on these 5 cards that I made using the 3-dimensional decoupage pages. Now here is an idea on how you can turn these layers into cards. I'm just going to show you for 2 of them, but you can repeat the same idea with all 5 of the layers. I'm just cutting out this Audrey Blue cardstock that was included in the kit, and I'm cutting it out to be 4.25 by 5.5. Then I will use on top one of those dies that give a little stitching detail. I also did cut out one out of white cardstock, and I'm just going to use one of my curved dies to cut out a couple of snowbanks, one for each of the cards that I'm going for. I used glue, and I'm sticking the snow at the bottom of my panels, and you can see I'm going for a little winter scene here. And all I'm going to do is to stick those cutout layers on top of my backgrounds by using foam tape at the back. Stick those panels on top of your card bases, and these are standard card bases, that's 4.25 by 5.5. I did use foam tape at the back of those panels. And by now you already know what I do on all of these cards. I just add snow with my Nouveau Drops. To make it look more interesting, make sure that all the dots that you add with Nouveau Drops are not the same size. Some are bigger, some are smaller. You can stamp your sentiment on the snow before you stick everything down with foam tape, but since I didn't plan ahead, I'm just going to stick my sentiment on top. I did use the Itty Bitty Holiday stamp set, which is one of my favorites this season, but of course you can use the sentiments included in the stamp set of the kit. In that stamp set you will also get snowflakes, so I decided to use one of them with white ink, and I'm just stamping in a few areas here and there. Here are some close-up photos on these 2 cards. I do have 3 more layers to turn into cards. I'm not going to do that for this video, but you get the idea. You can follow the same design. Now I'm going to bring in another pattern paper, and I'm going to show you an idea on how you can use that. If you cut it in half, you will end up with 2 layers, perfect for 2 slimline cards, mini slimline cards, 3x6. So I'm just going to turn one of these layers into a card. You can see how it comes together, and you can do the exact same thing for the second one. I cut out a panel to be 3x6 using a die that gives a lovely detail all around. If you don't have that die, just use your paper trimmer to cut out the white panel into 3x6, and then the layer is slightly smaller to give a little border all around. stamp a sentiment on a thin strip of paper. I did happen to use a sticker here. I also did use a very thin strip of red cardstock to help that sentiment pop even more. I'm keeping it really simple for this card. I'm adding my Nouveau drops for the snow. And if you have any dies that cut out Christmas foliage, now is the time to use them. I just used these holly berries to add an extra element of dimension. And we still have this lovely pattern paper with the four images that we can use. Now, these are great for window cards. You can have these behind the window and it's going to look just lovely. Use a square, use a circle. I decided to use one of them as the background for a shaker card. So I'm just going to use one of the dies, of the circle dies, to cut out a window. And here is my panel. I'm going to show this idea on just one card, but you can repeat it for all four of these backgrounds. So just turn your window panel at the back, add some double-sided tape, peel off the tape and then stick on top a piece of acetate. This will create your lovely window and then you can go ahead and add some foam tape all around your circle to make sure that your shaker elements are not going to fall. I measured how long I need this piece to be and I'm also cutting it to be smaller, thinner, since this is quite big, and I'm going to place the extra back in the roll so I can use it in another time. I peel off the backing from the foam tape and this allows me to manipulate it easier. I'm going around my circle making sure that those two ends are going to connect nicely so nothing is going to fall. I will use my scissors to separate the image from the rest of them. I added white glitter on top of my background and then I'm going to place the window on top, making sure that I see whatever I need through that window. If you have any of those snow globe dies in your stash, then these backgrounds would also be great for these kind of cards. I'm going to place that on top of a panel that's 4.25 by 5.5. I'm going to finish it off by adding a sentiment. You can stamp any of the sentiments from the stamp set included, or you can use any die-cut sentiment that you may have on your stash. You have plenty of area underneath that window to stick anything you need or to stamp anything you like. I'm embellishing with a holly berry again at the top. Grab your Christmas foliage dies and embellish your card with anything you have. Another thing that would work for this card would be to use snowflake cutouts if you have any of those dies. I completed my sentiment by sticking down the word Christmas. I added three red sequins to work as berries. And my card is finished. To conclude, I have to say that this is a must-have card kit, probably one of my favorites from the whole year. It makes it super easy to make cards. I was able to put together 12 cards for this video, but I have to stop myself since this video is already super long. And remember, I have more of these layers to make 3 extra cards of this style. I also made this mini slimline card out of half of the pattern paper and I have the other half to make one more. And I have 3 more of these backgrounds to create even more shaker cards or window cards like the last one. And I have plenty of the busy pattern papers I did share in a previous video how I would like to play with them. Plus, I haven't even touched the images from the stamp set. So here are again some close-up photos on all the 12 cards that I made for today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget to click the like button as well as share this video with your friends if you find it helpful. I hope you'll all have a lovely weekend and until next time, stay safe.